Quite a few people have asked to learn more about the solar system I installed that serves as my power source for my off-grid cabin. If you'd like to learn more about that off-grid solar cabin, which you'll see in this video, please click this link above in the upper right-hand corner. Here you'll see two 100-watt solar panels on top of my cook shed. These can be purchased on eBay or from a solar supply shop, which are easily found on the internet. I suggest the panels face in a southerly direction if you're situated in the upper Midwest of the Northern Hemisphere, as I am here in northern Michigan. I'd also suggest you increase the angle about 3 times greater than what I have on my panels if you're going to be using these in a snowy climate to help facilitate the shedding of snow in the wintertime. Here I run the cabling down through the roof and onto the back side of the shed. The cables connect with what are called M4 connectors, which are very simple to use. My cabling then runs along the top and down the sides of the inside of the back of the shed, and from there it runs underground and underneath my cabin. Be sure to give yourself a little extra cable. You'll never know when you need it, but believe me, you're going to need it. Here my cables from the panel come up through the floor to my charge controller. I don't endorse any particular product here, but this is an example of a charge controller you could find on eBay for $27. It's a rather simple device. Your leads from your solar panels connect to this and then to the battery, and it prevents overcharging of the battery. It usually has a digital display as well that tells you what your battery levels and input and output levels are. Here you can see on my display that I've got about 8.6, 8.7 amps coming in, and by the press of a button, it will tell me that my battery level is 100% and my output is about 6.4 amps. What that means is the charge controller is not charging my battery at the current time because I've got more energy coming into the system, into a battery that's already 100% full. Everything that I have on in the cabin right now is running completely off the panels. Let's talk batteries for a moment. I'm using one VMAX charge tank 125 amp hour battery for my system. My system is very basic because I'm only running 12 volts throughout, and I'm only running lights and fans. I don't have any high amp energy needs like TVs or appliances, so I've kept this very simple. This battery is available for $299 on the internet, and although I don't endorse this brand, it has served me well now for about 2 years. I do recommend the use of an AGM battery due to the low risk of gassing, since you'll be using this inside of a confined space. You might wonder what kind of lighting did I use throughout the cabin. I found these on eBay and purchased about 15 of them and strategically placed them in the cabin, pointing toward the ceiling and at each one of the bunks. They run on 3/10 of an amp and they pivot to point in almost any direction. They also have an individual on-off switch. The low amperage means that if I left one of these on, it would take about 17 days to drain my battery. If you watch the video on how I built this cabin, you'll note that I put in USB power ports in each one of the bunks that power a fan and also can be used to charge your phone at night. I also installed LED strip lighting in between floor joists of the loft above. It reflects upward and then is reflected down from steel wainscoting that I placed in between the floor joists. 15 feet of the strip lighting will set you back about $8 and can be cut to any length you want it to be. One of the keys to efficient power use in an off-grid solar cabin is to set up a switch panel so that you can adjust the lighting to whatever degree that you want. This will ensure that you don't waste power unnecessarily. This is an 8-gang switch panel that could be found on eBay. I suggest you click around on Amazon and eBay. You'll find all kinds of interesting 12-volt light fixtures available, which will suit whatever your particular needs may be. Here I encased a stainless steel utility box in wood and added a 12-volt switch to it. Hanging from it is a recessed light fixture that hangs above my kitchen table. The lighting is a standard E26 socket that screws into the light fixture and runs off a 12-volt. This too can be found on Amazon and eBay. Although I'm in northern Michigan, we do get hot days in the summer. This ceiling fan runs on 1 amp and comes along with a 6-position switch, which allows me to tune it back and use even less than 1 amp if I so desire. It also comes with a remote control, which you could take to bed with you if you desire.